ask you, Trick Trick, because I don't understand, what is the no-fly zone? What does that mean? Because, I mean, I've come to Detroit and had marvelous times.
We shot movies out of Detroit.
But what does no-fly zone mean?
It was for record labels.
Okay.
When record labels used to have, like, street teams, and that was back in the A&R days. Mm-hmm. You know, they would have a promo team, take the artists, you know, A&R take the artists to different locations, and it was like they were just coming to Detroit and wasn't picking up nothing. It was like they would charge the local artists to perform. They would charge the local artists to perform, and the local artists would bring 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 people sometimes to this event that will pay to get in. It's like, how is you charging them and they bringing you revenue?
Wow.
You know, and then, you know, when it kept happening with the little homies and they was just doing it because they got money, like, you know, fuck that, man.
Meaning paying, paying to get on the phone.
Yeah, it was just
on
so
their,
much.
Their own stage, technically. Own,
exactly. Right. Right. And it was radio as well. Right. Like, you know, the Summer Jams events didn't consist of mostly Detroit artists. They consist of everybody from everywhere else, and the Detroit artists would get charged.
Wow.
And I was like, fuck that. Stop everything. Wow. Now the only entertainment around this bitch gonna be what's here.
Right.
So we gonna get acquainted with what we got around these corners, and then we'll start letting a few trinkets in one at a time. And if anybody violated, we'll deal with that accordingly, you know.